दैट्स व्हाई हम लोगों ने जो सिस्टम्स बनाए हैं बट वी हैव डेवलप्ड देयर इज वन इज अ ह्यूमन सेंसर माइक्रोवेव ह्यूमन सेंसर वी हैव डेवलप्ड इन आवर ऑल प्रोडक्ट्स कि अगर कोई ह्यूमन बॉडी नियर बाय इन अ 3 meter रेंज कम देन इट ऑटोमेटिकली गेट ऑफ एंड इट विल गेट ऑन आफ्टर 30 or 40 seconds.
I would like to answer
Dr. Jethwa's question about reflection of UV light from the wall.
Wall, yeah.
It does get reflected from the wall. It's basically a light, you know. Only thing is we are not able to see, but otherwise it's a light. So if your wall is very well polished or if it is tiles, it does get reflected to a certain extent, like any other light would be. And a second question was about transmission through the glass. So all the glass which we use in our windows, like the Modi floor glass or whatever the commercial glass is, they are not UV transparent. They block UV.
Okay.
The UV transparent glass is very expensive because it has to be absolutely pure from borosilicate and it has to be, it cannot be even soda lime. It has to be fused parts. And to have a fused quartz glass in windows would be spending several of your wristwatches for making one window. So all our normal glasses are non-transparent to UV. So and that we have done the test inside, keeping a fluorescent meter inside the OT and outside the OT, having a glass OT. So that I think it would be impossible for us to afford a UV transparent glass of that size. It will be very, very expensive.
So all mobile UV units should be having the UV tubes exposed outside, not inside any glass case or anything.
No, if you want to contain it in a glass case, you have to have very expensive UV transparent glass, right. Not the ordinary glass. So the best way is to have a jali. जो अपने ट्रीज के फर्दे लगाते हैं ऐसा एक जाली रख देने का दैट्स व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू फॉर आवर ट्रॉली नाउ सो दैट व्हेन अ मैन मूव्स इट दे डोंट एक्सीडेंटली स्ट्राइक एंड ब्रेक द ट्यूब
या दैट इज द
पॉइंट व्हाई नॉट टू गो फॉर यूवी एलईडीज
यूवी एलईडीज आर मच मोर एक्सपेंसिव
नहीं
नो 11
नहीं नहीं
सी
आई वांट टू ऐड वन थिंग बिकॉज़ जो यूवी एलईडीज हैं They are still more than 266 or 280. Still.
Right.
Okay.
Mukesh, 254. Yeah. Listen me, I just had a contact with Ushio and Equisense technology about their LEDs. 254 okay. nanometer emitting LEDs, one seed costs $10. That is 780 rupees now. And you need 40 seeds. To have 40 watt tube light.
It would be something like 32,000
rupees for an UV LED tube light.
To convert to UV LED.
To convert to UV LED, whereas this LED. One is 2,000.
Yeah.
So that cost difference is too big and it's against the LED.
That's what the question I asked actually. Ki ye jo my, the UV LED which I have, I don't know exactly what frequency it emits, but it is written over there. It is 254 nm, 11 watt UVC LED.
If you measure in the UV UV spectrometer,
yeah,
then you realize.
Yes, yes.
You can take it to, is, you yeah. can bring it to Bhavnagar and Central Salt, we have a UV spectrometer. You can
okay,
can
and they will tell us what is
wavelength okay. and intensity both.
Yeah.
The second thing, I'm sorry.
We are having a complete lab to test everything about the okay. spectrum. We have established the lab in 2010 for our whole okay. LED products.
Now, second thing, Mukesh, about the... Yeah. Tube UV versus LED UV is that LED UV's emission keeps on decreasing as the time goes. LED is not forever. It is bright only for 1 year and then after second year it starts dimming up. Unless you have very, very excellent heat management system. And again, to have that excellent heat management system for a 40 watt LED UV tube is another expense over and above that 32,000 rupees for the LED. So I don't think LED UV will soon
feasible in
is feasible in this field.